I mean, there's a million Muslim voters, and they are really, they really despise Justin Trudeau now. They've finally realized that he is an LGBT extremist, that he, that the Liberal Party opposes their moral values on family and sexuality, and a lot of them are turning now to look at conservatives as a party that they can vote for, as candidates that they can vote for. So it's a winning issue, and I don't think any conservative needs to be afraid of that.
They want kids to make life-altering decisions that are irreversible. Like, once you take those hormone therapies, your voice has changed, you might have acquired new health problems. I mean, it's not okay. And they are caring for it just in the wrong way. So we need to fight for kids.
Here I'm Xalabo for Ribbon News, and I'm still at the convention of the Conservative Party of Canada. And today, I have an interview with Jack Fonseca about the 10 policy that they really wanted to pass. Jack Fonseca is the political director of Campaign Life Coalition. And the 10 policy that they wanted to pass is mostly about protection of children, drug and substance abuse, palliative care, vaccine mandates, euthanasia, mates, protecting female sports, national senior care strategy, child protection, and also the essential maternity and on newborn produce. So can you talk a little bit, because you are really happy your policy that you wanted the most passed. Can you talk a little bit about it?
Yeah, so today it was the initial voting. The final voting happens tomorrow, but we had a clean sweep on the policies that we endorsed, the pro-life, pro-family, pro-faith and freedom policies that we wanted to pass. The 10 that we endorsed are the 10 that were the top vote winners, and they've advanced to the final vote tomorrow. Mm-hmm. So hopefully they will become official party policy. And we're really happy about that. And they include, you know, a real prize, something we're really hoping for, a policy that condemns child sexual mutilation with puberty blockers, cross-sex hormones, and genital mutilation surgery. Mm-hmm. So that was passed by an overwhelming margin. You know, everyone supported that. Even an MP spoke in favor of it. And there was another one against gender ideology that passed, which was policy number 999, which was in opposition to biological males having access to female washrooms, change rooms and showers, other intimate spaces, as well as female sports. You know, so that, if it passes tomorrow as well, will become official party policy. The Conservative Party opposes biological males in female spaces and female sports. Mm-hmm. And so those are great wins. These are ideologies that have been a cancer on society. They're really tearing society apart, destroying women's sports. Women are getting raped in prisons, in women's prisons. They're getting raped in shelters because of gender ideology, and women's shelters by biological males who identify as trans. So this is a very welcome win today, and we hope it'll carry on tomorrow. We also had a policy pass that we endorsed against vaccine mandates that explicitly states the Conservative Party supports medical freedom, freedom of conscience for religious or moral reasons.
So, Michel Barlog, I know that you were one involved to try to adopt the motion about the surgery on children for gender dysphoria. Why is it so important to talk about it?
It's important to talk about it because we're dealing with a vulnerable population. We're talking about kids, we're not talking about adults. And just to put things into perspective, our brains don't fully develop until around our mid-20s. So for kids to make these life-altering decisions that will impact the rest of their life is fundamentally wrong. And not only that, those surgeries and the hormonal therapies that they do, they cause issues like cancer, osteoporosis, and a lot of it doesn't alleviate the mental health issues that they're experiencing. So I think it's very important that we protect our kids. If they want to make those decisions later on in life, then go ahead. But when they're kids, let them be kids.
Mm-hmm. For the people who understand a little bit, can you explain who you are and your background?
Sure. My name is Michelle Badaluk. I am a psychologist. I have a Bachelor of Child and Youth Care and a Master of Science in Psychology. So I'm quite well versed in this issue.
Do you have any concern that maybe mainstream media can use those policy to try to paint badly the party, saying that they are infringing the rights of some people?
I think that will be very hard, so long as you know, people know how to speak dismantle the false narratives of the mainstream media. You know, the fact of the matter is that the winds are changing against gender ideology. We've seen now with the various provinces, Saskatchewan, Manitoba, New Brunswick, and Ontario coming out against schools hiding transgender transitioning from parents of their own children, that the tides are changing. The polls are showing 75% to 85% support amongst Canadians for requiring schools to get parental consent if their child wants to use an opposite sex pronoun or impersonate the opposite sex at school. So the winds are changing on this issue, and I think it's a winning issue. I don't think conservatives have to be afraid of it. I think it's a winning issue. I think it's going to help them win the next election and form a conservative government, and a majority conservative government at that. We've seen that even with the Muslims. I mean, there's a million Muslim voters, and they are really... they really despise Justin Trudeau now. They've finally realized that he is an LGBT extremist, that the Liberal Party opposes their moral values on family and sexuality, and a lot of them are turning now to look at conservatives as a party that they can vote for, as candidates that they can vote for. So it's a winning issue, and I don't think any conservative needs to be afraid of that.
Why do you think that those topics and those policies are so controversial in the society?
Yeah, I think it's only controversial to the Liberal media, you know, the CBC and Toronto Star and those types, because they're ideologues, they're radical activists, you know, the editors and the writers and the reporters at all these mainstream media outlets. And so it's only controversial to them. To average Canadians, average voters, it's not controversial to say that children shouldn't be put on puberty blockers and cross-sex hormones that are going to make their bones brittle, you know, expose them to all kinds of side effects, including cancers, stunt their growth, affect their brain development, and lead one day for many of them to amputating perfectly healthy body parts. That's not controversial to most Canadians. It's only controversial to the media. So I don't see these as controversial issues. I think just conservatives, including conservative MPs and the leader, need to be strong and bold and not apologize.
Why do you think it's so a big controversy to speak about this surgery that children is now like using for changing their body?
I think it's a big issue because the left has made it a big issue. We shouldn't be confused about who we are. And if we are, please seek help. It's okay to seek help, but please don't mutilate your bodies at a young age. Your body is a temple. Respect your body.
Mm-hmm. So the vote have been made. Can you a little bit explain if it was a positive or negative vote?
Yeah, absolutely. It was positive. It moved forward. So tomorrow we're going to further discuss the ones that went forward, and we're going to see which ones we're going to put through to the policy booklet in the future.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And what do you think about the fact that Liberals seems to not care about this issue?
Well, they do care, but they care for the wrong reasons. They want kids to make life-altering decisions that are irreversible. Like, once you take those hormone therapies, your voice has changed, you might have acquired new health problems. I mean, it's not okay. And they are caring for it just in the wrong way. So we need to fight for kids.
So we are on the scene at the convention of the Conservative Party of Canada. And if you want to support our work, please go over rebelfieldreports.com and consider to make a donation if you believe that Rebel News needs to be at those events to show you the other side of the story and to bring you more information. So thank you in advance for every donation.